This tutorial will show you how to get started using Zotero. Zotero is a type of free archiving software that allows users to create databases of information. Zotero is special in this regard as it is able to pull metadata from research information and create citations, for example, author names, article titles, case law citations, etc. We will start at the Zotero homepage, www.zotero.org. From this screen, select Register from the top right. Choose a username and password. Zotero will send you a verification email. Once you have followed the link in that email, you may sign in to Zotero. Now that you are signed in, click on the Download button at the top right. Zotero's download page will give you several options. You may download a plugin for Firefox or a standalone version of Zotero along with an additional browser extension. For this example, we will be downloading the Zotero standalone program with the Chrome extension. Once downloaded, the standalone version of Zotero will be located on your desktop. Next, double-click on the Zotero desktop icon to open Zotero. Now that we are in Zotero, we can start adding documents to the database and organizing them. One way of adding documents to your Zotero library is by dragging them from folders already on your computer. For these types of files, you will likely have to manually enter the article name and other metadata. However, if you use the Zotero Chrome extension on websites like JSTOR or Google Scholar, Zotero will automatically pull the metadata and enter it for you. In this example, we'll be searching for articles on Google Scholar. After entering my search terms, if I see an article I'd like to add to my Zotero database, all I have to do is click on the yellow folder icon located in the search bar at the top of the screen. A pop-up will open and I can check the box next to the article or articles I'd like to add to my Zotero archive. After selecting my article, a box will appear at the bottom right of the screen to show the download progress to the Zotero archive. I can then locate my article in the Zotero Unfiled Items folder. Now that I've located my file in the Unfiled Items folder, I can now tag it with keywords and place it in a folder so that I will easily be able to find it, and so that anyone in my group who is doing similar research may be able to utilize it. Before tagging my article with keywords, I should create a folder to place it in. Clicking on the New Folder button at the top left of the left-hand side of the screen will let me create a new folder. After I name that folder, I can drag relevant items into that folder. When I have my article selected, I can see all of the metadata that Zotero pulled for me. However, I must still add tag keywords manually. I can do this by clicking on the Tags tab at the top right of the right-hand panel of Zotero. Then I can type in keywords related to the article and create tags by clicking the Add button. Similarly, I can create notes relating to the article by clicking the Notes tab. In order to share this research with others, I have to create a group. To do this, I'll go back to the Zotero website and click on the Groups tab. Now I can search for pre-existing groups or create a new group of my own. For this tutorial, I'll be creating a new group. Once I click on the Create New Group button, I will be taken to a new page where I can select a name for my group. After I've done that, I'll choose the type of group I'd like to create. The choices are public open, meaning anyone can view and join the group, public closed, meaning anyone can see the group but must apply or be invited to join, and private, meaning only members can see the group and members must be invited. For this example, I'll create a group with public closed membership. Now I can enter in a group description, choose the disciplinary subject of the group, upload a group picture, and decide whether to enable comments. Next, I can start to invite new group members so that I can share my research. I'll click on the Member Settings button underneath the group name and then click on the Send More Invitations link. Then I can invite members by email address or Zotero username, and I can add a personal message. Once I've sent the invitations and people have accepted membership, I should click on the Update Roles button to make each of them administrators so that they will also be able to add documents to the group library. In the next part of the Zotero tutorial series, I will show how to further utilize Zotero to organize and share research materials. For questions, comments, and other information, please contact a reference librarian at the UW Law Library website. Librarians may be reached in person, by phone, by email, or by chat.